Love me do.
In heaven.
For this is the day when we all are able to witness the wedding and the marriage of Kenora Lillian Goodrich and Corey Gerald Kallstrom as they pledge their lives to each other and begin the journey of marriage.
The first reading that the couple selected is a beautiful piece titled The Union from Robert Fulghum's From Beginning to End. You've known each other from the first glance of acquaintance to this point of commitment. At some point, you decided to marry. From that moment of yes to this moment of yes, indeed, you've been making promises and agreements in an informal way. All those conversations that were held riding in a car, or over a meal, or during long walks. All those sentences that began with when we're married, and continued with I will, and you will, and we will. Those late night talks that included someday, and somehow, and maybe, and all those promises that are unspoken matters of the heart. All these common things and more are the real process of a wedding. The symbolic vows that you are about to make are a way of saying to one another, you know all those things we've promised and hoped and dreamed. Well, I meant it all, every word. Look at one another and remember this moment in time. Before this moment, you've been many things to one another. Acquaintance, friend, companion, lover, dancing partner, and even teacher. For you have learned much from one another. Now you shall say a few words that take you across to the threshold of life, and things will never quite be the same between you. For after these vows, you shall say to the world, this is my husband, and this is my wife.
Celebrate with you, Kenora and Corey, your love for each other and our love for you. And we're here to witness the words of love and promise that you will soon speak to each other that will carry you across the threshold of life we call marriage. Special way, Kenora and Corey wanted to thank you and express to you their love. So at this time, they would like to give the mothers roses as a way of expressing gratitude and love. Dear God, please guide Corey and me to have a strong and healthy relationship. Teach us to come to each other in times of need. May we be open to each other and willing to listen and communicate. Help us to trust in each other and live together a life that enables us to grow in grace and humility. Remind us to always have faith in you. May we laugh daily and hold each other tight. And help us to have a safe and healthy family together with children. For this I pray. Amen. Dear God, please grant us the power of compassion and understanding in order to help us communicate and resolve issues better. Please bless us with healthy children, and may we grow and flourish together. Please give us the gift of good health so that we can spend many years together, growing old together. Amen. Will you who are gathered as friends and family today, will you also pledge to Kenora and Corey your love and support not only on this day, but in the years ahead? If so, would you enthusiastically say, I will?
I will.
Yes.
Hi, Corey.
choose you, Kenora.
I choose you, Kenora.
To be my wife.
To be my wife.
I promise to respect.
I promise to respect.
Honor and cherish you.
Honor and cherish you.
And I will trust in you and all you are.
And I will trust in you and all you are.
I will strive to be a better person.
I will strive to be a better person.
And to make each day easier for you.
And to make each day easier for you.
No matter what the situation.
No matter what the situation.
I know I'll be all right.
I know I'll be all right.
As long as I have you by my side.
As long as I have you by my side.
I will choose to love you each day.
I will choose to love you each day.
Loving you unconditionally.
Loving you unconditionally.
Staying true to you always.
Staying true to you always.
As long as I live.
As long as I live.
I, Kenora.
I, Kenora.
Choose you, Corey.
Choose you, Corey.
To be my husband.
To be my husband.
I promise to respect.
I promise to respect.
Honor and cherish you.
Honor and cherish you.
And I will trust in you and all you are.
And I will trust in you and all you are.
I will strive to be a better person.
Strive to be a better person.
And to make each day easier for you.
And to make each day easier for you.
No matter what the situation.
No matter what the situation.
I know I'll be all right.
I know I'll be all right.
As long as I have you by my side.
As long as I have you by my side.
I will choose to love you each day.
Will choose to love you each day.
Loving you unconditionally.
Love you unconditionally.
Staying true to you always.
Staying true to you always.
As long as I live.
As long as I live.
The rings have become such a perfect symbol of all of this. They remind us of the preciousness, the permanence, the beauty of your union. And so may the rings that you do give to each other as gifts today remind you and all those who see them on your fingers of the promises you have just spoken. As you place this ring on Kenora's finger, please repeat these words after me. With this ring, I give you my promise to love you forever as your husband. Kenora, as you place the ring on Corey's finger, repeat after me. With this ring, I give you my promise to love you forever as your wife. Corey and Kenora, you have spoken your vows. You have exchanged rings as a symbol of your promises. Therefore, by the power vested in me by the state of Minnesota, I now pronounce that you are husband and wife, and I'm honored to be the first to introduce you to the rest of the world as Mr. and Mrs. Corey and Kenora Kallstrom. You may now, for the first time, as husband and wife, kiss.
Happiness in marriage is not something that just happens. A good marriage must be created. In the art of marriage, the little things are big things. It is never being too old to hold hands. It is remembering to say I love you at least once a day. It is never going to sleep angry. It is never taking the other for granted. The courtship should not end with the honeymoon. It should continue through all the years. It is having a mutual sense of values and common objectives. It is standing together, facing the world. It is forming a circle of love that gathers in the whole family. It is doing things for each other, not in the attitude of duty or sacrifice, but in the spirit of joy. It is speaking words of appreciation and demonstrating gratitude in thoughtful ways. It is not expecting the husband to wear a halo or the wife to have wings of an angel. It is not looking for perfection in each other. It is cultivating flexibility, patience, understanding, and a sense of humor. It is having the capacity to forgive and forget. It is giving each other an atmosphere in which each can grow. It is finding room for the things of the spirit. It is a common search for the good and the beautiful. It is establishing a relationship in which the independence is equal, dependence is mutual, and the obligation is reciprocal. It is not only marrying the right partner, it is being the right partner.